So, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to talk a little bit about supply chains, supply chain management, and of course, sustainable supply chains and the management of sustainable supply chains. Maybe you already heard about supply chains. This means the cooperation between different companies from the supplier of the supplier to the customer of the customer. This means the economic success is not due to a company itself, it's due to the whole performance of the supply chain. And the question is, how can companies get and share the information from their suppliers and clients in order to be able to make optimal decisions? These decisions affect the whole supply chain and are very important for the whole economic access. For this reason, supply chain management has been one of the most important tasks during the last decades. But on the other hand, in a global world, global supply chains lead to environmental burdens, lead to social effects, not only to economic effects. And this means sustainability and how to assess and how to measure and finally how to manage sustainability in supply chains is still one of the most important tasks in our economy. Sustainability in supply chains means that companies and decision makers in companies have to know about the resources which are used from their suppliers, the emissions produced by their suppliers, and of course, on the customer side, they have to consider how the customers are using their products and what happens with the end-of-life products in the recycling or in the disposal phase. In order to get all those information, of course, we need trust in such a supply chain. It's not only competitiveness, we need long-term contracts, and all of the actors in such a supply chain have to think and have to consider the same goals. This means not only economic benefit, but also social and ecological benefits for the whole supply chain and, of course, for the whole society. And the question is how to assess the sustainability of supply chains. There are many methods in literature, but most of these methods do not distinguish between the various geographical regions and the spatial differentiated processes. This means manufacturing processes, transportation processes, in order to come together and then to compute the right data and information. This means that design and management of a sustainable supply chain requires consideration of spatial differentiated processes and the necessary data. And this is one of the tasks of the sustainable supply chain management, that industrial decision makers are aware of the various alternatives of designing supply chains and measuring not only the economic but also the ecological and social benefit of sustainable supply chains in future. So one of the most interesting tasks, and I hope that in your class you will learn about the methods and discuss and get ideas which are necessary for a better future for all of us. Thank you very much for your attention.